threats are made into the clothes we wear, right? So if somebody gifts you something, if it is your birthday or any other occasion, if somebody gifts you money, what we usually think, we will think we will buy new clothes. But sometimes we will also think we shall buy clothes to our parents. Let's give gift of clothes to our parents. So whenever somebody gives you money, we think of buying clothes with them. Then we think of sometimes buying a sari for mothers. To buy a sari, we have to go to a shop. Then after going to shop, we see lots of varieties of saris made of different cloth materials. So after going to a shop, we see different varieties of cloth materials. So if we touch and feel, then only we can know what are those different fabrics. Everything we have to touch by hand and see, then only we can decide which sari we are buying, either a silk sari or a cotton sari or a Banaras or a Kanchipuram silk, like that. So usually the things which are around us are all usually made up of fabrics. What are the things around us? The bed sheet on which we sleep and we cover bed covers, then blankets with which we cover ourselves, then the curtains which hang in our houses, then tablecloth, duster of the school, then towels, bags also, the school bags and the gunny bags. All these are made up of some type of fiber, some or the other type, either cotton or some other material. So everything which surrounds us is usually made up of fabric. Fabric is nothing but a cloth-like structure. So there are lots of varieties in fabric. Fabric is a continuous piece. So suppose if ever you go to shopping with your parents, suppose if your dad wants to buy a cloth piece for making a shirt, then you see fabric cloth pieces will be continuously rolled into a thin structure and be kept in the shelves. Like for example, we have Raymond fabrics, Rimmel fabrics. If we go there, we see the fabrics will be rolled into long layers and will be compacted and put in the shelves. So fabric, we can say, is a continuous piece. So if we say, if we want 1 meter fabric, 2 meters fabric, they will cut us and give. And if we buy a sari, we buy a blouse piece, we buy a fabric piece matching to that. So fabric is a continuous piece, thereby we can say, suppose if we want to get a blouse stitched, we will go and say that we want 80 centimeters fabric or we want 2 meters fabric. Fabric is nothing but a cloth. So like that, we can say the fabric is a continuous piece, that is, threads will be continuously knit together to form a cloth. So what are the varieties of fabrics we see? They are cotton, silk, wool, synthetic or polyesters or nylons. So cotton, silk and wool we usually know. These are sourced from either plants or animals. And these are the artificial fibers. Synthetic fibers is artificial fibers. That is polyester or nylon. So cotton clothes we wear mostly in summers. Woolen clothes we wear mostly in the winters. And silk fabric clothes we usually wear during the weddings and other occasions. Then synthetic things also we wear in our daily life. Your uniforms are somewhat a mixture of a cotton and a synthetic fibers. So whenever we are talking of a fabric or a fiber, so fabric is made up of yarns arranged together. Yarns are nothing but a group of threads. So fabric or a cloth is made up of yarns arranged together. So when we are talking about yarns, what are yarns made up of? Fabric or a cloth piece is made of yarns arranged together. That means many threads arranged together. So many threads arranged together form a yarn. So what are yarns made up of further? So you know that yarns is split into thin threads during stretching. Generally any cloth piece, when we see threads coming out of it. So if we take a cloth piece and we stretch it like that, we can see thread-like structures. So this is a yarn. This is made up of a group of threads. So here it is explaining that yarns split into thin threads during stitching. So this is a fabric and here some threads are coming out of it. So if I keep on stretching, it is increasing in length. So yarns are made up of lot of thin threads. So yarns split into thin threads during the stretching process. Then these thin threads, so these are yarns, I told you, is made up of thin strands of threads. So these thin strands of threads are further made up of some more thin strands called fibers. So yarn is basically, when you stretch any cloth, you see threads coming out, right? So those threads are nothing but, so fiber is made up of group of yarns. fiber is made up of yarns, and yarns are made up of fibers. Fabric is made up of yarn. You understood? Fabric is made up of yarn, and yarn is made up of fiber. Fabric is nothing but a cloth piece. The cloth piece is a continuous piece made up of group of threads. Those group of threads are known as the yarns. These group of threads are further made up of thin strands of threads known as fibers. Clear, right? Fabric or cloth piece is made up of group of threads called yarns, bundle of threads. So this bundle of threads, yarns, are further made of thin strands of threads called fibers. So thin strands of thread are made up of thin strands called fibers. Cloth piece is made up of yarns. Yarns are nothing but many threads arranged together. So these yarns are further made up of small threads called fibers. So that is how small fibers or threads make up to form a big yarn. Big yarn make up to form a fabric or a cloth piece. So when we talk about fibers, they are lots of threads. Think of fibers, think they are threads. We get threads in the market, right? Small reels of threads to stitch anything. So whenever I talk of fiber, think thread. Whenever I talk of fabric, think cloth. And whenever I talk about yarn, think of big piece of cloth, right? So when I am talking of fiber, think I am talking about reels of threads. So fibers or threads, they are of many varieties like cotton, silk, wool and jute. So how are these fibers made up of? From where do these fibers come? So these fibers are sourced from either plants or animals. So as we know, cotton is grown in the fields in cotton plants. Same way jute plant is also there. So plant source fibers are cotton and jute, whereas animal source fibers are wool and silk. So wool is extracted from either goat, sheep, camel or yak, and silk is extracted from an insect called silkworm. So that is how fibers are of different types, and fibers are sourced from either animals or plants. And then wool and silk are animal sourced fibers, and cotton and jute are plant sourced fibers. So other than these fibers, we have something called synthetic fibers, which are made up of chemicals. They are neither sourced from plant nor animal. So examples of such synthetic fibers are polyester, nylon and acrylic. So our uniforms are usually made up of polyester material. It is a mixture of two or three fibers. Our uniforms are not 100% cotton. So see, these are the varieties of fibers, and these are the sources from which fibers are obtained. What are the animal fibers? Silk and wool. And what are the synthetic fibers? Nylon, polyester, acrylic, etc. So moving on to plant fibers. The first plant fiber we learn is cotton. So usually the most of us wear the clothes made with cotton when usually we are at home. All our daily wear clothes are usually made up of cotton. And in the summer seasons we wear cotton, because cotton absorbs the heat, and we wear light colored clothes because light colored cotton clothes absorb the heat and we do not feel very warm because of the temperatures. Then what are the uses of the cotton? Wicks for the oil lamps. Because have you ever observed your parents or your grandmothers, they take a ball of cotton and they start rolling it into threads. So that is called wicks. Then they light it. If you have been to a temple, or if you have observed any puja or any specific spiritual activity at your homes, you might have seen that oil lamps are lighted in front of the god, or in front of any freedom fighters also sometimes. For in that oil lamps there will be thread-like structures to which the fire will be lighted, right? So that is known as a wick, W-I-C-K, wick. So those wicks are usually made up of cotton. We can make the wicks by hand, or even machine-made wicks are available in the market. So wicks are nothing but the cotton is made into fine threads, cut into long threads and lighted in front of the god, or any during any spiritual activity, or in front of the freedom fighters. Like that, at many occasions oil lamps are lit, or if we are having any annual functions or like that, even in the inauguration ceremony we lit the lamps, right? So that is how it is done. Then the mattresses which we sleep usually on the bed, and the sofa mattresses in our homes are usually made up of cotton fibers. Then quilts. We cover ourselves with cotton quilts during the winter seasons. Quilts keep us warm because they trap the air inside. So that is the reason, quilts. Then pillows. We rest our head on pillows, right? So all these things are made up of cotton and cotton fibers. So this cotton is usually made up of further cotton fiber wool. So the ball of cotton contains small thread-like structures known as cotton fiber wool. And so where is this cotton sourced? So cotton is sourced from agricultural field with black soil and warmer climate. It is grown in an agricultural field as a crop where the color of the soil is black and the climate is usually warm. In most summer, in areas where there is less rainfall, cotton can be grown where the temperatures are usually warm. And if you ever observe a cotton soil during traveling on the national highways or any village to village or any city to city, we see some fields, right? So if we observe a cotton field, then generally we can clearly make out the color of the soil to be black. So source of the cotton fibers is agricultural field with black soil and warm climate. Then if you see in a cotton field, the cotton will be grown as the fruit of the plant. So that fruit of the plant, that cotton is known as the cotton ball because it looks like a ball-like structure. So after growing, it grows into a lemon-sized structure, lemon or lime. Everybody knows lemon or lime, right? So after growing, the fruits or the cotton balls are lemon-sized structure. So after fully maturing, after reaching a mature stage, after they are fully grown, they burst, and then the seeds covered with cotton fibers can be seen. If you have ever seen a cotton ball, there will be seeds inside. Above the seeds, the cotton fibers will be covered, right? So after fully maturation of the fruit, the cotton plants, the lemon-sized cotton balls burst, and then the seeds covered with the cotton fibers can be seen. So clear, right? The seeds covered with the cotton fibers will be seen in that cotton fruit, which will be called as cotton ball. So cotton field looks like a snow. Why? Because all the plants, when they bear fruits and the fruits burst, it everything looks like a whitish colored structure. The top of the plants, the plant top or the tree top, looks like a whitish colored covering. So that is the reason it looks like a snow. Suppose if we have snow, we generally have a white colored appearance, right, which looks like a cotton. Suppose if we want to make a model of a snow, how do we make it? Definitely with the help of cotton only, right? So that is the reason cotton field looks like a snow, because after bursting, after maturing, the cotton balls look like a snow stone. The cotton balls look like snow-like structure. So that is the reason cotton field looks like a snow. And then these cotton balls, from these cotton balls, the cotton is hand-picked. That means the seeds are separated from the cotton balls. Then fibers are separated from the seeds. This process is known as ginning. What is ginning? Cotton is hand-picked from the cotton balls and fibers are separated from the seeds. From the cotton balls, after harvesting, after cutting the cotton balls from the plant, the cotton is hand-picked and separated from the seeds. The fibers, the whitish colored part, is separated and the seeds are thrown away. This total process is known as ginning, and sometimes it is done by machines and sometimes as well as hands. So this was about cotton. Now moving on to the jute. Jute is also obtained from plant. Jute is a plant source fiber. So jute is obtained from the stem of the jute plant. Stems or branches are almost similar. So they are the long branch structures, stems. Then it is cultivated during the rainy season. See, cotton was cultivated during the warm climate and usually during the summers. But jute will be cultivated only during the rainy season. And these plants, cotton, was harvested in the fruit stage after maturing. Whereas jute is harvested only during the flowering stage. As soon as the flower develops, it will not be allowed to develop further into a fruit. It will be harvested. That means cut off from the plant. Then after harvesting, stems are immersed in water for a few days. Immersed means dipping. So you take a tank full of water, a small tank, dip all the stems after cutting it from the plant. Then after some time, due to continuous dipping of those stems in the plant, the stems rot. What do you understand by rot? Rot is nothing but spoiling. Suppose bread, if you keep bread outside in the air for a longer period of time, you see greenish colored growth on the plant, on the bread, right? The greenish colored growth is nothing but the rotting of the bread. Same way here, if we dip the stems, if we put it in a long period over, if we put the stems dipped in water for a longer period, then the stems rot or spoil. Then the separation of fibers is done by the hand. After the stems rot, the fibers are separated by the hand. Then they are rolled into yarns. That determines a group of threads, and then cloth is woven from them. That is, fabric is woven from those jute fibers. And generally, the cotton and the jute fibers are environment friendly. They are made by hand. Nowadays, when we go to the market, we see many jute bags. They are environment friendly. And you know, Mahatma Gandhi, father of the nation, he used to encourage the use of the plant sourced fibers, right? So this was about the cotton fibers, which are sourced from the plants.